Hello, this is Kenneth Camp, and I am here with Nella Davidsey, a good friend of mine. And today we are having this interview for my website, kennethacamp.com. And Nella and I have known, along with Danielle, we've known each other now for 8 years, I guess, something like that.
Yeah, I didn't count it, but
I know
a long
it's
time.
at least that long. And when Danielle and I lived in Thailand, we did a lot of work with Nella and their ministry, and our hearts have been captured by what they're doing. So I'm not going to steal any of Nella's thunder here, but I'm going to just go through some questions with Nella today and let her tell a little bit of her story and the story of the ministry that they have there in Thailand. But Nella, would you tell us, where you are working? I've mentioned Thailand a couple of times, but where specifically are you working in Thailand?
Yeah, I'm working in Thailand in a place called Pattaya, and it is a tourist place and one of the famous places in the world for sex tourism. So it is a very international city, on the coast of Thailand.
Yes.
Beautiful place on earth.
Yes, it's very beautiful. How long have you been there?
In Pattaya, I've been 15 years. I came there in 1999 with a small team to start the ministry. And so that is 15, almost 16 years ago.
Wow. That's hard to believe, I'm sure.
Yeah, it goes so fast. This is the 20th year actually that I am in Thailand, because
Okay.
in 1995 I moved to Thailand and lived in the north for the first 4 years,
Okay.
and then in 1999 I moved to Pattaya.
Very good. So I'm sure some of my listeners are wondering where you're from. Where is your home? Can you tell us
Yeah,
where?
I'm from Holland.
Okay.
Yeah, and I lived in Holland till I left to go and do DTS with YWAM in Denver,
Okay.
and then after that I moved to Thailand. So it is Holland and Thailand that are the two countries I belong to.
That's true. Very good.
Yeah.
And you're there in Holland right now.
And right now I'm on furlough for 2 months in Holland. It's very cold here,
Yes.
but it's great to see family and friends here
Yes.
back home. Yeah.
Very good. Well, take a little time and describe the kind of work that you're doing there in Thailand. I don't know if we've mentioned the name of the ministry, but it's Tamar Center. Can you describe what the kind of work it is that you do?
Yeah, I mentioned already that I'm working in Pattaya, which is a city famous for sex tourism. And there are many girls, about 20,000 women working in prostitution in the city, even more, I think. And most of these come from the northeast of Thailand, and they try to find a foreign husband to support a family. And what Tamar Center does is try to reach these women and give them an alternative option. And basically, we try to reach them with the gospel. Many come from a very broken background, often abused as a child already, many problems in the family. Many of them do have children at very young age, divorced, and then they end up in Pattaya trying to find a better future. So Tamar Center visit the bars, teach English classes to get more relationship with the girls, and then we have a vocational training, which they can choose between hairdressing, bakery, sewing, and computer.
Yes.
And it's also Bible training.
That's great.
And we see many of these women, young and Christ, they really receive a fundamental transformation in their lives and in the way of thinking. And it brings a lot of reconciliation with the family and with their children. So besides this, Tamar Center also reach out to the families. We go to the northeast of Thailand, Isan. That area is called Isan. And the girls come from very small villages, and we do a lot of evangelism and children's programs in these villages. So we try to do the prevention side in Isan, and we try to do actual rescuing the girls in Pattaya. So
That's
that's basically very short what
No,
we
that's
are doing.
good. That's very good. And I was excited when you began doing the work in the northeast part of Thailand, reaching into the villages. And right now, I didn't catch if you said this, but right now y'all have a training going on, right? How many girls are part of the training right now?
Yeah, we do have 9 girls in our training program.
That's great.
And yeah, so they are at the moment discipled. They are in the process of becoming, getting to know Christ, knowing forgiveness, and making a new start in life. And they also receive a skill which will help them in the future with a new income for the family. So it's always an exciting time.
Yes.
It's a lot of it's a difficult time too, because there's a lot of opposition and spiritual warfare. And but there are also opportunities to teach them more about Christ, about forgiveness, and about healing,
Right.
because it's very broken people that come. And but it is amazing to see the power of the Holy Spirit and the power of God's love transforming their lives. This
That's
is
awesome.
always encouraging.
Yes. That's exciting. For those that are listening or watching, I will have a link to Tamar's website where you can get more information about the work that they're doing, not only in Pattaya, but also throughout Thailand. Is there a recent story that you think you'd like to share? Maybe something exciting that has happened or a success that you're excited about?
Yeah, I think I want to share the story of one of our girls. She actually came to our ministry through another organization. She was very young, she was an orphan, and she ended up working on the beach as a prostitute in Pattaya at a very young age. And she got a Thai boyfriend who was HIV positive, so she got infected also. And she got 3 children with him. But then she got so sick, she was at the point of dying. And she was helped by a Christian organization who sent her to us. And she's trained now as a hairdresser. Her health is a lot better. Her
Good.
blood is so much better, and she has more strength. And before the training, she prayed and she said, "Lord, if you really exist, just give me strength to live and raise my own children. And also bring my children back to me," because the children were not with her, they were in another with another organization. And yeah, just before I left, she gave a testimony and said, I took prayer requests and God answered both, because I have so much strength and I'm so proud of the job that I have now." Because she said before, when my children were asked, like, "What kind of job does your mom have?" they couldn't give an answer.
Sure.
And now they can proudly say, "My mom is a hairdresser."
Right.
Two of her children are back with her now in our center, and the third one is coming soon.
That is
So
great.
it is beautiful to see this, restoration in the family, and see this, this young lady being restored, and God healing her, and giving her a new chance in life.
That is great. I know you have many stories like that, but that's a great story. No doubt, especially for the years that you've been serving there you face challenges. You've kind of alluded to one or two, but for those that want to pray for you and your team, what are some of the challenges that you face?
In the city of Pattaya, like, the environment is very hard, because you every time when you go out, you just see sin around you. It's a very dark place. You see many men walking with young girls, and you see many men walking with young boys. And you're surrounded by sin and by darkness. So it is very important to pray for our spiritual health and emotional health, so that we stay strong and positive and have faith. And so that's very important. For me personally, in pioneering the work and building up the ministry, it has been hard. You need to do everything. Like, you need to raise funds, you need to make these, you need to meet you scars. No, but and that has been one of the challenges for me, I think. But God has always been faithful at the same time.
Right.
Other things is sometimes the unity, working together in
Yes.
a missionary environment is sometimes difficult. Together, you have the same friends, you live in a very small environment. So pray for good
Yes.
relationships, good friends, healthy
Right.
teams, very important.
Yes. Very important. Nella, that's very helpful, and I think it'll be helpful for those that that really have a passion to pray for you and support you that way. I know you have people come and serve with you, like short-term type things.
Yeah.
How can someone, or what type of person, or can they come as individuals, or does it always have to be a team? Speak to that for a moment, and then we'll wrap things up here.
Yeah, basically, we have a lot of people coming for short-term. Mm-hmm. We pre 3 months or longer. Mm-hmm. So they have some time to adjust and work with us. And almost everyone can come and help. If you have administrative gifts, that's very welcome. If you are an intercessor, you have a prayer room. We really would like to see the prayer room used more. If you are a baker, a hairdresser, if you are creative and can make cards and help us design more products, you can work with the children. I mean, there are so many things you can do. Long-term, we also need long-term staff, because that's one of the challenges, that people want to come short-term, but really long-term, dedicating their lives for 5 years or 10 years or longer. Right. It's very hard because you need to learn the language. Not many people speak English, so that is a very long commitment, right, and sometimes hard to get people long-term. Teams are very welcome. We go to the bars 3 times a week, and the teams can join in with that. They can join in with English class. They can organize special parties for the girls. So we buy them sometimes out of the bar and then have a special night for them, where we just spoil them and let them know that they are worthy. There are many opportunities to serve here.
Very
good. So we're well prepared for that, and anyone that's interested can contact us.
That's great. And again, I will put the link to Tamar Center's website on the blog here, and also a Facebook page, and you can contact that way. Would be a good way. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Great. Yeah. Well, thank you, Nella. I'm going to sign off here, and look forward to seeing you soon, okay?
Yeah, okay. Blessings. Thank you so much. Bless you.
Bye.